The first sign in ophthalmology is defined as a presence of proteins in suspension in the aqueous humor. These proteins in suspension transform the aqueous humor, in principle absolutely transparent, into a cloudy fluid. This increase in turbidity is in proportion to the number, to the amount of proteins present in the suspension. These proteins generally appear as a consequence of the increased permeability of the vascular wall due to inflammatory processes, which makes the flare sign an important sign of intraocular inflammation. It is very common in uveitis and other intraocular inflammations or infections, such as endophthalmitis. In this video, we are going to see how the intensity of the flare sign is graded and, by extension, this classification is considered as one of the parameters of the degree of intraocular inflammation. How are we going to measure the flare sign? We will do it with the slit lamp and we will look for the best lighting with which we can see the iris as clearly as possible. We must observe the iris from the front, as we see a photograph on the right, following the optical axis. And we will measure the difficulty that we find in seeing the iris clearly. If we see the iris just blurry, we will classify it. We will reflect it in the medical history with a one cross, flare of a one cross. If we see the iris in a blurry way, two crosses. When we find it very difficult to see the iris looks very blurry, three crosses. And we will reflect in the clinical history a flare of four crosses when it is not possible to see the iris. And this would be the classification of the sign of flare. We have to say that being a qualitative classification, there may be variability on the part of the observer. However, it is a useful classification since it will help us to establish the degree of intraocular inflammation and its evolution, its improvement or worsening throughout the entire inflammatory process. Thank you so much for your attention.